Hi, good morning, everyone. Thank you, Pranesh, for the introduction. I'm Dr. Danya, and my talk is on the scalpel-holding resident, how to tackle surgeries. For the next 8 minutes, I'm going to discuss about the right mindset to approach surgeries. The objectives of my talk are to develop a positive attitude, to relieve anxiety, and to boost the confidence of the residents, to provide moral guidance to deal with complications, and to understand the role of hard work in surgical training. This is the dream of every resident who is to undergo cataract surgical training, that is, to sit in front of the microscope and get the microscopic view of patient's eye, to perform skillfully, and to have an ideal postoperative outcome on the next day with a clear cornea and minimal inflammation with an uncorrected vision of 6/6. What we most often forget is that this is what we'll be doing for the rest of our lives, and thus it does not matter whether we have a rough start or a smooth start. Eventually, every one of us is going to be a meticulous surgeon. But the path which we go through is going to be filled with challenges, and our attitude towards these challenges will decide how quickly we bounce back and go forward in the training. For example, when we have a premature entry, it complicates the entire surgery, and so we may be upset. After battling with our emotions, it is essential to come back to reality and gather all the courage and confidence and to lift oneself up. Our trainers and seniors may motivate us, but it lies within oneself, the capability to regain faith in oneself. No external force can do this but ourselves. With this kind of attitude in mind, let us enter into the presentation. Going back to the previous slide, looking through the microscope is what we like to do, but looking outside the microscope is equally important. Understand the overall OT layout and the patient flow within the OT. Observe the procedures done by our OT staffs before we start the surgery and after we finish the surgery, like how they get the OT ready in the morning, how they set the tables, and after the surgery is completed, how they shift the patients and counsel the patient, how the OT is cleaned and sterilization procedures are being carried out, and thus we can appreciate our hardworking staffs. Learn to give a good block to keep the patient pain-free, comfortable, and cooperative for the entire duration of the procedure. Observing surgeons' hands from outside the microscope will help us learn how to hold an instrument and manipulate it. For example, how to chase out an air bubble from the anterior chamber using viscoelastic injection through side port. So look around and observe. Every minute spent inside the OT is valuable because there are a lot of activities taking place in various areas of the OT at a given point of time. Giving quality eye care is vital. It is more important than doing most steps of the surgery or more number of surgeries. We should know our limitations and call for help as and when needed. So, quality is more important than quantity. The next aspect is to give a complete patient care. Whenever possible, it is good to see for ourselves the patients on whom we are going to operate on the next day and do a thorough preoperative evaluation. Talk to the patient to earn the patient's trust. On the day of surgery, receive the patient in the OT. Once again, check if the pre-op workup is complete, log the patient, and then start scrubbing. It is crucial to follow up the patients postoperatively, especially in case of any intraoperative complication. Make sure that the patient is compliant to the treatment given by us. Only if we are familiar with the instruments, drugs, and machines in our armamentarium would we use them wisely. For example, in a mid-dilated pupil, Coughlin's hook or intracameral adrenaline would come handy. So, know the tools. It is a fact that some residents struggle during the initial days of surgical training, whereas some can complete an entire surgery by the end of first week of training. For some residents, it may take an entire day of wet lab practice to take the first bite of suture, leave alone tying the suture. So do not compare yourself with others. There are no shortcuts to success. Practice suturing in wet lab every day throughout the period of training, at least 50 sutures per day. This helps to develop a good hand-eye coordination. It also gives an idea about depth perception and how to focus on the area of interest. Practice the steps of surgery on goat's eye or cadaveric eye whenever possible. OSCAR scoring keeps track of our progress in surgical training. It is an invaluable tool to make us realize where we go wrong during the surgery. Reading books, not just once, but a revision of the entire book after having done a few cases will help us understand the content better. For those residents who operate on a limited number of patients during the residency, recording one's own surgery and reviewing them with as many seniors as possible would help in refining the skills and training and techniques. Dealing with surgical complications is inevitable in our journey. A good surgeon is one who understands what led to the complication. This can be done by discussing about the surgery with the trainer or a senior surgeon who can analyze better and give a solution. This is an opportunity to start reading actively and learn new concepts. Have a notebook to pen down the struggles faced and how to correct them. This way, we will not repeat the same mistake again. We may not be able to perfect all the steps of the surgery in all our cases, so try to perfect one specific step in each case. Watch videos of senior surgeons to know how they manage complications, and watch videos of your own colleagues so that you can learn from their mistakes. Finally, do not give up. Your responsibility is to do the best job that you can at a given point of time and to ensure that your best keeps improving every single day of your career. Thank you.